blossom on the leaf still. Someone picked the bloom recently.
Another seeker of Pimpernel.
Another?
Grennist has sent countless young druids into the forest. They emerge drained, with a blank stare, and with no flower. And they never speak of what happened. I've asked Grennist to stop the folly. He looked at me and laughed. But the fun's over. One of our novices, Ramond, has failed to return. I've come to find him, alive or dead.
What do you know about this forest?
Not much. Funny, isn't it? A druid should know every tree, every bush. But even we know not to venture to some parts of the isle. We can subdue animals, but not monsters. And the word is, one has made its lair here.
A Leshen? An Axebrim?
Sadly, I don't know. As I said, those who have entered do not speak of who or what they saw.
Listen, you're looking for a druid, I'm looking for a flower. Let's go in together.
Why not? I could use the help of a tracker. Lead the way.
Flower. No petals.
Hoofprints, but of bipeds.
Oh, no, no, oh, stop, please. Ha ha. Oh, this is great. No, no, stop. Please! Stop it, that tickles! Two can play this game, you horny goat woman.
Unhand him, hellish creature. Ramond, step away from her!
Ah, calm down. I've not been harmed. I came here...
You don't know what you're saying. She's cast a spell on you.
Nonsense. I need no spell. These boys come here themselves. In fact, I must use magic to drive them away. Make them go home. Only Ramond was nice, so I let him stay.
I see through your lies. Your wretched charm won't work on me. I shall kill you here and now, monster!
don't see any reason to kill her. She's a monster, sure, but a sentient one, and basically harmless.
No such thing. Just as there's no dry water, no cold fire. But if you'll not help, very well. I shall tend to her myself.
I'd advise against it.
I will return. With one who does not carry a sword for show.
Why did you take my side? I'm afraid you'll be sorely disappointed. I don't generally couple with witches, especially not out of gratitude.
Tell me why not. Is it the scars?
I detest when a man smells of blood. You witches always reek of it. Fiend blood, chort blood, and these are my brethren.
You're right. But unlike fiends and chorts, you...
have ample breasts and a pretty face. I know. Their lack of these attributes, is that what makes them easy to kill?
It's a bit more complicated than that. But never mind. No means no, I get it. Can't think of another way you can repay me. I'm looking for Pimpernel. You know this forest. Maybe you could help me.
I shall take you myself. And you, Ramund, go pick some more violets. Just the indigo ones this time.
Indigo? You mean blue?
No. Indigo is indigo. Men.
Why you need all these flowers?
Nosy, aren't you? Wait and see. Pretty, don't you think? Bellflowers, violets, kingcups, pimpernels. I must pick some edelweiss. Take one, but no more. I've put a lot of work into making this cavern cozy.
Peacefully now. Distilling recipes. Parchment's a little faded, but legible. Lucky. Bit of mash left. Here's where the mash goes, probably. Done. Now to boil the mash. Ought to be enough. Time to cool it down. Distiller.
Did everything you asked?
Phenomenal, my boy! So, Fridtjof, shall we begin?
The sooner the better. We've a long night ahead of us.
The ritual is only for members of the Inner Circle. Thus, my dear apprentice, you must wait outside. Under no circumstances must you enter. We shall begin your tutelage come morn.
Will you finally tell me what the ritual's about?
Nay, nay. No one likes a meddler. Suffice to say, it's a burning matter now. Shoot!
Must have another. That's good stuff.
Aye, as the base from Moss Gordon and spirit from here hell. Good times, Fridtjof. Good times. Finally, something other than damn potions and transmutations.
Guess the ritual's not over yet.
Gerd, I thought I told you to stay outside. Only druids of the Inner Circle.
Sharkle Smirkle, let the boy have some fun. He's earned it.
Fine. Pour yourself some. Gerd, let the lessons begin.
Drink hard and study hard. I like the idea.
Yeah. I call it stimulation and assimilation. First you stimulate, and then you assimilate. Shut down. Right. Let's start with ingesting toxins. Best approach, practice makes perfect.
I've practiced a lot already. Good thing.
I'll make learning my secret method easier. Look, you take the potion like this, and gulp.
Who said old age is a burden?
What do you want now? I've taught you all I know.
Got anything to sell?
I do, but it's expensive.
See ya.
I'd prefer goodbye.
From the
balance of
you best take that back. You defiled sacred ground. The gods will never forgive you for this.
He ain't welcome here, witch.
Always did know how to win, friends.
I was provoked.
Mm-hmm. Saw it happen. Wanted to talk to me about something?
Amos Far Ipsis. A specialist on djinns. Heard of him? I found a tome he'd penned in the Emperor's library. Far Ipsis set off for Skellige one day and was never heard from again. I asked some of the local folk. Some here still remember him.
They know what happened to him?
The locals say they last saw his ship off the coast of Hindisfjall. Then a once-in-an-eon storm broke.
So he's probably fish food by now.
Not necessarily. I must learn what became of him.
Why? Do you know him?
No. It's not the mage who interests me. It's his djinn.
Why are you even interested? Djinns are dangerous sometimes, and malicious all the time.
I remember. But the advantages outweigh the risks. If I can tame a djinn, I shall gain incredible power. And that could be useful to us one of these days.
You sure this mage actually had a djinn?
His book strongly suggests he did. He describes taming one, harnessing energy from its power.
Storm wouldn't pose a threat if he'd had a djinn. He could just utter a wish.
Perhaps he had none left, or something unexpected happened.
All right, so what exactly do you expect me to do?
You must help me find this djinn. I've no gold to offer in reward, but I shall be ever so grateful.
Since you put it that way, fine, I'll help you.
Thank you. A boat awaits in the harbor. Come.
See, you've managed to prepare everything already.
I have.
How could you possibly know I'd agree?
I didn't. Decided to risk it.
Let me hold you, sir.
Fancy a pint when you're done.
Oh, no.
Lead the way.
Just once, you might try to take the initiative.
Would you even let me?
It would depend on the situation.
Respect, Witcher.
Last night was...
The ship carrying the djinn sank somewhere in this area.
Not too precise as leads go.
I'll cast a spell on our boat. We'll know if there are any wrecks on the seafloor below us.
All right, let's get to work.
Mind if I take the helm?
I got a choice.
No.
I'm not sure this djinn thing's a good idea.
We managed to seize one before, do you remember?
Of course. Dandelion almost lost his voice that time.
How lucky your exorcism saved it. It was poetic.
Yeah, how was I supposed to know that incantation meant begone and plow yourself?
You should have studied foreign languages.
Gonna keep bringing that up for the rest of my life.
Of course. Your last wish effectively assured it.
My wish was about us being together always, not about you mocking my every mistake.
Do what you wish for. And when your wish is granted, you must accept it with all attendant circumstances.
Yeah.
And as for your missteps, I don't rightly see why I shouldn't laugh if they're amusing. There's something here, on the bottom. It's too deep here. You can't dive that long.
You underestimate me.
On the contrary. After all, I asked you for help. I'll cast a spell. It will slow your heart for a time. You can stay submerged longer.
Asad Aich, Cryde Rithorn.
Ready. Careful down there.
And you know I hate it when you read my mind.
Strictly speaking, I'm not reading your mind, but using telepathy. Besides, you've nothing to hide, right?
Wouldn't admit it if I did. Not the point.
See anything interesting?
A shipwreck and a cavern. I'll look inside. Snapped masts, busted planks, and a whole swarm of drowners. Probably drawn by the corpses of drowned crew, then made their nest here. There's also a Clan Drummond figurehead.
Not the right ship. Come back up.
Now.
Wherever the leads take us.
Say we find the djinn. What'll we do? Ask for a beautiful house? And a palace? And a queen's crown?
Are we still talking about the djinn? Have we moved on to a talking fish?
Doesn't much matter. Both make wishes come true. What would yours be?
You learn in due course. Something's here. Another wreck.
Let's see if our djinn's down there.
Look around, but be careful. Look for something that might indicate it's the Mage's ship.
Beautiful craftsmanship.
What do you have?
A warhorn, bearing Clan Haymai symbols. Got a chest, really old. Must have fell off the wrecked longship.
Can you open it?
Hoping for pirate treasure.
I hope to find the djinn. Try to open it.
Now that's what I call war booty.
Have you found the djinn?
No, but I found something that could be just as valuable to me as the djinn is to you.
skeleton. Somebody pinned his skull to the deck with an axe.
A death worthy of a Skelliger.
Clan emblem indicates a Dimon man, so he was from Pharaoh. Yen, doubt any of these boats were the mages. These are old sunken longships.
Come back, then. We must search elsewhere. You're getting better at this.
Go even quicker if you helped me down there.
I prefer to observe matters from up here, most definitely.
Yeah, like when we were looking for the Golden Dragon and the avalanche swept us off the trail. Me clinging to the remains of a bridge for dear life, you gripping my waist, admiring the view. Remember? The chasm below us was breathtaking. Rustling trees, a lazily flowing stream.
I remember. Though I found myself admiring what I had right in front of me. Something strange about those rocks.
And there's something on the bottom. Let's see what it is.
See something?
Something doesn't do it justice. A huge crater, as if a meteorite landed here.
I must see it.
Diving in after all?
No, I shall cast another spell, to see through your eyes. Now relax. Aesu faultia badem ein aichte ilivade. That is no meteorite crater.
What is it then?
The effect of teleportation. A powerful force cut out a fragment of the seabed, rocks, and everything lying within the teleportation zone.
Always claimed portals were dangerous.
I believe we're on the right track. Look for anything that might contain a djinn.
Fine, but get out of my eyes. Too cramped in here for us both.
Aesu faultia badem ein aichte ilivade.
Silver. Pearl-encrusted cutlery. Ship belonged to someone awfully wealthy.
Amos was no pauper. It could very well be his ship.
No djinn here, but there's something you ought to like.
What?
Half a seal.
That'll do. Come back up.
Only found half. Can you do anything with this?
I can use it to locate the other half, to within a dozen yards.
And once we find that, we should find the djinn.
Exactly. Ready? I'll take us there on the count of three.
Oh, no, not another portal.
Stop whining. One, two... Three.
Said you were gonna go on three.
I did. Look, we must search the area.
Yen, not so fast. Gotta tell me what this is about first. Why do you want this djinn?
But you already know. A djinn's power is priceless to a mage.
That I know. But I also want to know how you plan to use it. Wouldn't go to these lengths if it wasn't something important.
You're right. It's important. Even very important. How long has this been going on, Geralt? This thing between us? 15, 20 years? We repeatedly split up, then return to one another. Something draws us to each other, but I can never be certain if it's a true feeling or merely a bit of mischief by a djinn.
So that's it? This is about my last wish?
You asked that djinn to bind us together forever. I want to ask this one to take that wish back.
Why would you want to do that?
To see what it's like without it. To see if we'll still matter to one another. Or if we'll be like two strangers.
What if I don't want to know?
I'm afraid you no longer have a choice. Come, let's search the ship.
Seems Amos was quite the eccentric, asking the djinn to lift half his ship to a mountaintop.
He didn't necessarily. Djinns are inherently mischievous. This one might have granted his wish and perverted it in doing so.
In that case, I'd appreciate it if you didn't wish I'd disappear from your life.
I've yet to decide how to word it. We should explore the ship.
Nothing interesting here. Nothing interesting. Interesting. Nice shoes. Looks like the impact with the mountain was so powerful it popped the wearer right out of them. Mage must have slept here. Blood. Someone was dragged across the deck. War left this mark when the ship suddenly tipped to one side. Nothing here. Nothing interesting here. Yen, think you should see this.
What do you have? It's Amos. Looks exactly like the etching in the book. Except his head was intact there.
Think the djinn did this to him?
No, it wouldn't attack its master. This looks rather like an unfortunate accident. When the storm broke, Amos must have uttered a wish like, take us away, anywhere, to a mountaintop, even. And the djinn granted the wish literally. They had a hard landing. Amos was thrown off his feet and against the wall. The bookcase did the rest.
Always knew too much studying could kill you. If he died while being teleported, Seal might still be on him. Behold.
Bravo! Come to the deck. I've an idea. Step back a bit.
What are you going to do?
Summon and tame the djinn. It's not likely to be happy. Stand at the ready.
Tame djinn. Rif kaishta en gaya. Kaishta et displair. Gevired mi castle.
Care to trade places?
Over.
Yes. It's all over.
Maybe we should sit. You look a bit dazed.
I'm not, but we can sit.
Feel any better?
I told you, I'm fine.
Don't need to play tough for me. That was a hard fight. Maybe not as hard as the last time we tamed a djinn, but still.
No comparison, I'm afraid. Half of Rhind suffered then. Now I'm merely a bit tired. Thank you for coming, Geralt. I'd have had a much harder time of it on my own.
Well, never could say no to you.
Perhaps that will change now.
Feel anything? That anything's different?
I expected... I don't know what I expected, actually. A bit of vertigo, perhaps. I thought... you'd become a stranger to me. That I'd look at you and not feel a thing. But it's not like that at all. Nothing's changed.
Jin might have cheated us after all.
Why?
Because I don't feel that anything's changed either. I love you, Yen.
And I love you.
What was that?
It can't be all sweetness and light.
Strange. Done that so many times. But it felt like our first kiss to me.
It was, in a way. Besides, once you say I love you, a kiss has to taste differently.
Maybe we ought to test a few other things. Amos's cabin looked cozy.
Not so fast, Geralt. We'll have plenty of time to visit cozy cabins later. But I doubt the world will end if we sit here a while. My, it's lovely.
Mm-hmm. Think the spirits of Skellige favor us.
Make it down that mountain.
What now?
Well, I'm due to appear in Vizima.
Yen, what happened back there?
It was very nice. Let's not ruin it by hashing out the details.
I'm going to see the Baron. Collect Uma from him, then we'll ride for Kaer Morhen.
I shall join you as quickly as I can.
See you, Yen. Take care of yourself.
Geralt?
Ever think about the past? About your time with the Hunt?
At times, I'm amazed we survived. Eredin's not usually one to leave witnesses behind.
That's just it. He didn't. Lost my memory when I escaped the Hunt.
Ah, yes. Your famous amnesia.
You didn't have it?
For a short time, only. Once the Emperor's mages got their hands on me, my memory quickly returned.
When the Hunt had you, hope they didn't hurt you.
Even if they did, I've no memory of it. The whole time's but a string of phantom images. Blood and fire. A wild chase through different worlds. All shrouded in fog. Though I do remember you coming for me. Trading your life for mine. I hadn't the chance to thank you then.
You'd have done the same for me.
I'm touched by your certainty. But you've yet to tell me how you escaped them.
Wouldn't mind knowing that myself. There are times I remember rushing forward, red riders around me. Next thing I know, I'm in the woods at the foot of Kaer Morhen. That's it. What did Eredin want from you exactly?
The same thing he wanted from you. You don't recall?
Draw a blank on most of my time with them.
We were bait, Geralt. Both of us. Eredin believed Ciri would come for us sooner or later and he would capture her. Fortunately, she didn't fall for it.
How do you go from being the Emperor's hostage to being his ally?
One day, the door of my cell opened, and instead of seeing the usual officer, I saw Emir. He promised to release me and grant me free rein of the Imperial Treasury, provided I did what he asked.
He told you about Ciri, and you accepted his offer. Why?
Shared aims make for strange bedfellows. I knew I had to find Ciri before Eredin did, and if any man had the power and the means to help me, it was the Emperor. Besides, Once all's said and done, he is her father.
Why didn't you look for me after you'd recovered your memory and your freedom?
I assumed you would recover quickly and find me first.
You had mages to help you. I was on my own.
Well, not entirely. Besides, I knew you'd fled the hunt. Eridan would never have let you go. He'd erased my memory, but you escaped. It was wholly possible he hadn't had the chance with you. And there were your Witcher mutations. I expected they'd stave off any serious injury.
Still can't get something out of my mind.
What?
Found something that might belong to you. That skull, some sort of accessory? If so, you've changed your style a bit.
It's a weapon.
Don't remember ever seeing you with that?
It's as you said. I've changed my style.
Thanks, Yen. See you later.